Welcome back. This video has been requested by a lot of people, and it's not really one that I'm wanted to do because I feel that my knowledge is super limited. I have only been doing cloth diapering for 7 months, which is not a long time when you think about how many years some women have done it for. But I'm gonna show you what I know, which again, it's very, very basic. This is what has worked for us. Valentina has been cloth diapered, but maybe only the first 2 weeks of her newborn phase. And that was because we were in the hospital for almost a week. And so there was just some adjustment that needed to happen. But most of the time she has been cloth diapered. So I'm going to show you what I know, which again is not a ton. I'm going to list just a couple of women that I have followed that I know about who has channels all about cloth diapering. So if you really want to know about cloth diapering and you want to know tips and tricks and all kinds of options and why this diaper is good and why this diaper is not that great and this diaper is great for skinny legs and this diaper is great for chunky legs, that I will leave in the description box below, because I can't tell you that because I have not invested all the time and I have not invested the money in all of that. One of the reasons why a cloth diaper is because it saves us money. It's great for the world. It's great for the environment, but it costs us a lot less money than paying for disposable diapers. And for me, I like to spend money on certain things, and diapers is not one of them. So for me, it's worth washing her diapers and reusing our cloth diapers. Because of that, I don't want to spend a lot of money investing in all kinds of diapers. However, there are many women who have, and they will give you all the information you need if that's what you're looking for. So I'll list just some of the ones that I know. I'm sure there's a ton more on YouTube, but these are just the ones that I know, at least the ones that are popular, have a large following. And I've learned some of the things, maybe most of the things that I know from them. Let's start with the newborn phase. I wanted to go a very inexpensive route. There are so many options, and guys, this video is not about how many options and what kinds of cloth diapers. That's not what this video is about. This video is just about what's worked for us. So I wanted to go the inexpensive route, and so that was the diaper and the inserts. So when she was a newborn, I decided to get the Thirsties diaper. So the one, they come in Velcro and they come in snaps as well. So you'll see this is the Velcro one. I like the Velcro one, especially when they're really little, because it's just super easy, you know, changing them in the middle of the night. I have heard that as they get older and they can actually pull these off, you might not want to do Velcro. So some people it works for, some it doesn't, but I've decided only to do Velcro in the newborn phase because I've learned from other women. So you have the snaps and you have the Velcro. Those are both Velcro. Let's see if I can show you some snaps. These are the ones that have snaps in them. So not so bad. Very tiny. She used to wear these. So these are the Thirsties one. The Thirsties ones, Thirsties are not considered cheap, but I read that they were really great and they worked for us. They have what's called the gussets, and that's these things right here. So it helps the leakage stay in, and it's just causes for some better support. So, she has chunky legs, but you know, these worked for her. And I really like them. So you just have the covers, they're called the covers, and you put an insert in them. Now these don't particularly have any snaps in them. Some of them do, at least not these. I'm not sure if any Thirsties do, but these do not have the snaps in them. So what I did was I got an insert to put in it. And the insert would be a newborn insert. Of course, when they're really tiny, these inserts tend to feel like they're really long, but as they stretch, as you know, the diaper stretches out, you'll see that it does fit in there. The insert would pick up everything. Now, there's a lot of trial and error with cloth diapers, and there's a reason why a lot of people have great intentions and go into it with the intention that they're going to stick with it. However, if you don't do enough research, if you don't take enough time to figure it out, chances are you're not gonna last in it, because it does take trial and error. For me, it took I wanted to learn from a lot of other women who have already done it, so I wouldn't have to do trial and error so much. But of course, you do have to a little bit, because every baby is different. Some leak or some pee more than others, and then where they pee is a question as well. Some are the front, some are the, you know, back or whatever. So this is a bamboo insert, and bamboos are really, really good. This is another bamboo insert that I have. This is another bamboo insert that I have, and this one actually you can snap. This is the mama koala one, and this one you can snap and make small. So when she was tiny, I would just put this one in there like that, and then that would be the insert for this diaper. And then now she still uses these, and then they're longer. So I really loved this. And by the way, you know, you're gonna have stains in your cloth diaper. If you put them in the sun, it bleaches it away. I just haven't had the chance to do that one to this one yet. But yeah, so these worked when she was a newborn. I stuck with inserts and covers for a while. When she started getting a little bit, when she started getting bigger and chunkier, that's when I started changing things up. For the newborn phase at nighttime, I would use these cool ones, and I don't remember the name of these because I actually got these from a site called, I don't remember what that name of the site was, so I'm going to put it right here because I'm going to figure it out and put it here. But you can get inexpensive diapers. They're reusable. They have been used, but their condition is usually really, really good. It allows you to be able to try different diapers, because these, I didn't buy them at the price that I would have if they were brand new, but I got them used and they turn out to be really, really helpful. So at night, they have like this extra layer, and I believe these are cotton. I would do this, and then I would use a snappy, and they're really, really cool. So this is what a snappy is. I got them from Amazon, and basically they clamp on each side and they stretch. Really, really cool. So instead of like, you know, old school safety pins, you put the snappies on and they attach like that. Anyway, and then I would put this in a cover. So this would be on the baby, just like this. And then I would actually put the cover on her. And it worked all night long. Now, of course, you know, you wanna change them, especially if they've pooped inside of it. But that's how we were for a long time until she grew out of that. During the next phase, which really, she was still a newborn, but her body was, you know, getting bigger. These are from 0 to 9 months, and they're still thirsties. But they're just a little bit bigger. And so these are the snap ones. I still had them in Velcro as well. But I use these. I got some of these on that site that I mentioned before. And some of them I got brand new, like through Amazon. Another one that I got from Amazon is this one. And I'll have to get the name of it. Sorry, guys. But this one is, oh no, it's Ecoable. I think that's how you say it. Ecoable, and it says one size, 10 to 35 pounds. And I would do this one at night too. And so it's super thick. I believe it's bamboo. It's like a blend, I wanna say. Bamboo, hemp, just kidding. It's hemp and organic cotton. And basically I would put this on her, and then I would put a cover on her. So this is just another cover. And that would be her night diaper. That's what worked for us. But I can do the link. I can put the link down below if you're interested in that. So that lasted until she got too chunky for that. Newborn phase and infant phase, we did covers and inserts. As she got a little bit older, like now, we are now using pocket diapers. And I decided to do pocket diapers because I wanted to do pocket diapers. The pocket diapers, if you don't know, they're like this. Now these are Alva babies. These are super inexpensive. I got them from Amazon. There's another brand that my mom got for me that I didn't know about, but they're pretty much just like Alva baby. I don't know any difference. They're called a baby goal, I believe. And then I'm gonna talk about these. Well, really, it's all the same. They have different brands, but they're the same diaper. This is Nora's Nursery, and these are just kind of a unisex color. So these are all the same kind of diaper. They have different brands on them, but the manufacturer must be the same because I can't tell the difference other than maybe the inserts that they sell to you. Some sell micro fleece, which from what I understand, the micro fleece insert, which of course I don't have right here, you don't ever want to actually lay the baby on the micro fleece, but you want to put it inside. So when I say inside, means inside the diaper. So it has a pocket right here, which you can pull out. This is a bamboo one, and I love these inserts. This insert came from the Nora's Nursery diapers with the black and white ones that I just showed you. I love these. They're very thick and they hold a lot. Bamboo has become my friend. So this is just, this diaper will actually, is supposedly supposed to stay with her until she's time for potty training. So I can keep the same set of diapers the whole time, which I think is just glorious. So obviously we have, this is the phase we're at right now. When she gets a little bit longer, then we'll completely undo it. But yeah, so we've already had to change it from this, because we were right here and it made it a little bit shorter, and now we're on this one. And of course, as you go out, it makes it wider, as you go in, more narrow. But yeah, these have worked for us. I just wash them. I wash my diapers every other day. I put the insert inside, straighten it out, and make sure it's all ready for her when I put it on. So I like these because even though it takes a little bit more work beforehand, you just go ahead and put them together. I put them in my drawer. When it's time to change her, just like a regular diaper, I pull it out and put it on her. So that's been working for us. You know, she has chunky legs, so these don't have the gussets like I showed you before. But another diaper that we do use is, I am at a loss for words, please forgive me. I am on very little sleep right now, so I will put the name of it right here. But these were gifted to me from a sweet, sweet friend through Instagram, and they're lemons, if you don't know. This is a Let's Make Lemonade channel, and there's a reason for that. So I thought that was really sweet of her. But these are really cool because they have a gusset here. So if your baby has skinny legs, these are really great for him or her, because it helps to catch any of the excess. We have these. These have worked for her because she's got some thick legs like her mama. So they worked for us, and I'm really thankful because they're super inexpensive, and I haven't had to pay a lot of money just for on-cloth diapers for that. So we've had a lot of trial and error when she was a newborn. We did the cotton, and that was enough for her. I could just stick this in the diaper, and that was enough. Then it wasn't enough, and so you just have to figure out. Like I said, you know, I used bamboo, I've used hemp. I've used just cotton, and then there's a blend of each one. You can find all kinds on Amazon, or go to the specific cloth diaper line and find the inserts. These are Thirsties that I got with my Thirsties diaper, and they're amazing. They hold a lot. I've even tried the cotton flour sack ones that I got like just straight up from Walmart. And these work too. A lot of women on YouTube just use a regular baby blanket and they put it in the diaper and it works. I mean, really anything works, guys. Just like the cotton ones. These are the tri-fold ones. These work. I use that on her now. And so at night, a lot of the times what I will do, actually every night, for now I'm using these cotton. And they're really, really big. Just kind of like the old school ones. These are just regular, just cotton. And I fold it for her, and there's all kinds of crazy folds, let me tell you. So if you want to look that up, you could Google it and look that up. I fold it and I use a snappy. I actually put two inserts in there because it helps to hold more urine throughout the night. I put two of these inserts, and these are the Geffen baby ones, and these are hemp and cotton blend, and they work really great for us. And I put that on her every night, and I just put a cover, and it works. And she, you know, at some point she's gonna grow out of this because she's already through all the snaps. There's nothing to adjust anymore, and this one fits like perfect. So at some point we're gonna have to move on. I do wanna buy the fleece cover. I forget what it's called, but it's basically just a fleece cover that you put over your whole nighttime, you know, combination. And it helps to hold everything in so there's no leaking. That's the next thing I want to get. And so also for, you know, with cloth diapers, you don't want to use just any diaper cream because it can mess up the diaper. So another person on Instagram got me hip to CJ's butter. It's really, really cute. And so they have all kinds of safe and healthy and really great smelling products for your baby's bottom. So this one I got is an oatmeal milk and honey shea butter balm. And because this is the time that COVID is going wild, a lot of places are out of stock for a lot of things. So they have really, really fun scents, but I got oatmeal milk and honey. There's nothing wrong with oatmeal milk and honey, but there's a lot of more fun scents. And this was just one of the ones that was there that hadn't been sold out. So this is a huge one. This is a new one. I already went through a smaller one that was a really great smelling one. And it comes in all kinds of forms. So this one, you just put it on your finger and you wipe on their bum. This is a quick stick one, which I actually haven't started using this one, but it's all by CJ's Butter. It's the same company, but if you wanted it in this form and then just kind of put it on their skin that way, you could do that. And then also this one's really great. I think it's one of the most popular ones because you just spray it and it's oil, you know, different oils. So the ingredients are coconut oil, olive oil, castor oil, vitamin E, and then just a sweet, soft fragrance. This is a great, great scent. They're all really fun, good scents. So this one's easy because you just spritz, and then you just kind of, I just wipe it on her, and then it's easy, especially in the middle of the night when you can't really like see. There's been many times, especially in the newborn phase, I'm just like with eyes closed. So yeah, I mean, it's the same. There's also different kinds. There's a couple of other ones that I don't even have here. So CJ's Butter, I'll go ahead and put the link down below too. And these are super safe for cloth diapering. Yeah. So again, guys, this is super basic. And I just wanted to go ahead and show you all just the options that have worked for us. For the wipes, I have chosen to do cloth wipes. Some people do cloth diapering and they use the disposable wipes, and that's cool. You do whatever you want. I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna go do it all. I didn't want two systems. I didn't want, you know, to have a trash can for the wipes, and I didn't want to have a reusable bin for the diaper. So I just wanted to be able to put the cloth in the diaper just like you do normally, like with the disposable one, and just throw it away. And so I put the cloth in the diaper. I have a little system where when the diaper is dirty, I do the same thing like with the ones, with regular ones, disposable ones. It's dirty, I put it like this, I put the wipe in here, I fold it, and then I go like this, and then I snap it, and then I just put it in the bin. And then once it's time to wash, I undo it and then just throw it into the washer. And I think I've said this already, but I wash it every other day. That's just what I've chosen to do because I don't want them to sit for too long. So I have chosen to do the cloth wipes. So I've gotten these from Amazon. I've also used just the regular baby bath wipes or baby bath cloths. So you could use those too. I like these a little bit more because they're thinner. But a tip and trick that I've learned from other mamas is I just got like a wipe warmer and I put water and your kind of soap, or you could put like an oil, like a great essential oil in there, whatever you want. And then water and whatever you want in here. And then I just kind of like stir it around. They stay nice and warm in here. And it works for, it worked for me. So that's what I've chosen to do. Now, as much as I wanted to try to get this video short, it just didn't work out because there's just so much to talk about and I barely even touched on any of it. So this is just what's worked for us. Again, there are so many great people out there who have a world of knowledge about all this stuff. So don't take it from me. All I want to say is that it works. It can work. You can make it work. I would just say have a great plan going in. Have a few different options. What I've always heard from women is that you don't want to go with one brand and then go to town and buy a bunch of that brand because you don't really know what's going to work out for your baby, especially when you're a first-time mama, because you're not really sure how your baby's body is going to be. And, you know, you might have multiple babies and their bodies might be different. So, depending on the size and the frame of your child will depend on which diaper is going to work for you. Just have a lot of trial and error, just going with that notion that it's going to take a little bit. It really doesn't take long. It just takes a few times to figure out, oh, that's not enough inserts. Oh, my baby's leaking. I need to find another option. But if you have different variations in different diapers and inserts, then you can figure that out quickly. As long as you just know it's going to happen. But when you think about it, if you have a disposable diaper, you're gonna have leaks with that too. So either way, you're gonna have leaks. Yeah, it's easier to just go to the store and go buy some diapers. But if you do your homework and you find these great websites that talk about cloth diapering, and I'll try to add as many as I can that I know of down here below. And again, my knowledge is limited. So if you cloth diaper and there are pools or resources that you feel that would be helpful to other women, please put in the comments below because I know that would be very helpful for other mamas. But this is what's worked for me. You can do it. It's great for your pocket. It's great for the world. And it's great for your baby's skin. I use disposable. I thought our washing machine stopped working. It was just a breaker issue. Thank God. I thought our washing machine stopped working and I went and got a pack of disposables. And let me tell you, I put it on her and I was like, I think I like this too much. But she ended up getting a rash. So, there's no ingredients that you have to worry about on your baby's skin. And it doesn't work for everyone, but it works for a lot of people. So I hope that helps. If you have anything you want to add to the comments below. I hear my baby crying, so I'm gonna go get her. You are on this journey of cloth diapering. Tell me what has worked for you in the comments below and tell me what is your favorite or favorites of cloth diapers so that other mamas can see because I know that's helpful for them. Until next time, we'll see you later.